is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Of course, you know, I'm ever smiling. Someone asks me whether I have problems, whether I don't have problems, I'm ever smiling. So, and more so when I'm seated next to ladies. Now, Kiai has been elaborating quite a number of challenges that women are facing in volleyball. One thing we notice is that a low turnout of fans at the stadium during women games. What is your perception about volleyball? I start with you, my lady from Nkumba.
Okay, my perception. Ladies' games always have few fans, and those few ones are the real diehards. Mm. The women in sports, actually, they're the ones who come to support. Other people don't come. Mm. They have a view that women's games are not interesting. Mm. Then also, also the women stop playing at a low age. Maybe when you're in your mid-20s, you stop. Those who produce go away, leave the sport.
Oh.
Yes.
But we've seen some of the ladies actually in other sports, not only volleyball,
yes,
who go give birth and come back. Best example, Serena Williams. She gave birth, but she came back.
It's determination and money.
Exactly. Yes.
I mean, if you have, Sharon, if you're making money, if volleyball is not your bread and butter, you're not going to be running around trying to come back and get fit quickly.
Mm.
But knowing Serena, this is her bread and butter. Mm-hmm. I mean, without tennis, she's not relevant, she's not making money, she's not... So you have to make sure you come back into the sport. These people are not paying, literally.
So, now, she has hinted on the point that I wanted to ask you. Are you guys being paid? Is there anything you're benefiting from volleyball as a player?
Yeah, as a player.
Besides health?
Yes.
We get education, socialization.
Do the education you get, the courses, some of those courses you acquire or you get at university, presuming to be for free, is it a course of your desire or you just go to do for the sake of just?
A course of your desire.
Really?
Because you're not forced to do any course. You choose a course you want, you do it. There's nothing like those force you do this and this course. If you go in a university, let's say, for the case of universities, if you go and you find the course you want is not there, then you're free to change the university of your own choice.
But then how, if you change to the other university and you fail to get a scholarship? Because basically you're saying one of the benefits is scholarship, free education. What happens then?
No, you got those ones which give out scholarship. If you can't get and you have money, then you change. You go to the universities that have that course.
Okay, so as a student who is at university, at Nkumba University, I presume you're a student, right?
Yes.
Don't you think you people have not done so much to mobilize your fans, the female fans at Nkumba University? What is that you've done or what is that you intend to do? To see that now you have these women, come and support you. Since it's an institutional team.
Maybe what we do, we keep on advertising around our course mates, our friends in the university, then they come and support us.
Is that really enough? Isn't there something better, maybe probably, anyway, I could have asked the management on this, because these are some of the things you can. Yeah. I get back to you. I get a ball rolling back to you. What are these critical challenges that you've seen? Probably she has not mentioned, or maybe something that you want to compliment about.
What I want to add about what she has said, actually those are the same challenges we have. You know, when volleyballers get pregnant, they take long to come back on the game.
2 years you're off.
Exactly.
Yes.
You know, and sometimes if you don't know how the game score, you are not going to get interested to go and watch this game. Mm-hmm. That is one problem we have. You can sit with someone and they keep asking, what has happened, you know?
See spikes coming in.
Eh? So if they don't know how the game score, people are not going to come on board.
Mm. Mm.
So what we have to do, maybe to encourage these little ones to join the game, because people have grown up, people are moving out of volleyball. But one thing I would thank people that have played volleyball during playoffs, they do come and support their teams. Yeah, they are there. I see some sportest guys. I've never played with them, but yeah, they come around and we are sportest and we like.
So how do you think we can fill Lugogo Indoor Stadium, that arena? How do you, because I imagine a day the ladies teams are playing and no men's team. It is only ladies. The league, like we can say in Uganda, if it is for football, netball, you're saying this is the women league. Now I'm looking at the league of women only. How can, what can we do to see that the stadium is at least full? That's what my interest
hard.
Is.
Then it is a little hard, but then if we can sometimes make this, make the indoor games free, I think they would have crowd. Like in Zambia, things are free, so you can see very many people come and support volleyball. Even the footballers down there, those guys are trained from the
Villa Park?
No,
no, like
the pitch behind
pitch
the
pitch
church.
Ah,
right.
Behind the
yeah,
church.
Yes, they
okay.
were there, and you know, of course, they would keep on asking, "What has happened? You explain." What has happened? You explain. But they were there
because we need to educate them.
Exactly.
I think one of the critical issues you're trying to target is we need to educate people on some of the laws of the game, how the game flows, probably how we
scores, yeah.
How what are the fouls. You know, it is not easy though. Even me, I remember when I was in high school, it took me so much time to know a foul in volleyball. So I didn't even literally know that there was even anything like a foul in volleyball. You know, for me, I would just enjoy everything. But anyway, it is a good setup. So Faith, what are some of the recommendations you think we could really?
I would first ask myself, am I the right person to give recommendations? But from what I've noticed, like except for the sportest grounds, they are in a very strategic location. It's a good location. If you're thinking of the fact that there is a community pitch next to the ground, and I think even they used to play university football league on there on some Sundays. So for them, if as long as the game's like on a Sunday, they will get some fans in, and they are very, very over the weekend mostly. My only issue would be is, as a club, what kind of outreach are you doing to ensure that the people in that community do not only watch volleyball at that point in time. How about if they also come in and, you know, how what do you do for kids who are in that area? Because that area is quite populated. There are quite a number of homes in the place.
Yeah.
So I feel like it's a safe kind of sport kids can play. They are inside that enclosure at the sportest ground. So it's a good thing, but I would like to know what is the club doing to actively bring more girls, more and more kids generally into the sport.
You know, for sporters, we are one club that we don't train people. You understand it? Yes, we know we want people that already know the game, and we are going to begin from there. We don't have an academy that, you know, we are going to start from maybe at this age. We start training these people like slowly up to this age. We don't do that.
So
that
you're not looking forward to
that? We have, the men have two teams, and I think it is working for them. Because if you are good in Tigers, the next season you can be transferred to sport.
Oh, it's like the junior team of,
Yes. And we have a number of people that have joined sporters that stay around in Zambia. They've enjoyed the game. They've seen the benefits of the game. And I'm sure they keep on talking to those other ones. And
actually, with sporters, to add on a little bit, you have a very high advantage because even you have one of the big football clubs, that side, AC Villa. And these are fans because for us in sports, for me, sports is sports. Where I get the sports, where I get someone like if I get Namutebi swimming, I would go there to watch Namutebi and cheer her up. These are some of the fans actually because I give an example of the lady Kampala Queens. The Kampala Queens fans, most of them are AC Villa fans. And why? Because they train around in Zambia there. So I was trying to see a way of how you can merge with some of these football clubs in the country. Probably, you never know. Because in sports, we share fans. There's no one who has a permanent fan. Would you look at that since you train within Zambia and the population is there?
We'd look at that, but the problem is regular games, we don't do them from Zambia.
That's why the challenge is.
Guys. We do them in UCU and in Nkumba.
Okay.
And if you told these guys, you know what?
Let's
we have
go.
Games, but they're in UCU, they're
it's
in
hard.
Nkumba. It is really hard for them to move.
True.
Yes, but when we have them there, they are there.
Okay.
Yes.
So what should we expect categorically tomorrow as we wind up? Tonight.
Today at 7.
Yes.
We are going to, you're going to have a very good game. It is going to be interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And we are going to win.
You're going to win?
We are going to win.
Uh-huh.
For tonight's game, it's a do or die. We have to win this game and see it off.
But the trophy is only one.
Yes, it's one, but we can't fight for it.
So help me here. The trophy is only one. And the two of them, everyone wants to win. So?
It's, of course, it's a semi-final playoff. Winner goes to the final to face either one of KCCA or Ndeje.
Mm.
But knowing how Ndeje came back from... I mean, they were like a phoenix from the ashes. Like, they are literally down and out. They even led the third set at some. I mean, KCCA led like five. I feel like this is going to be a tight one because we saw in game one. Both teams are comfortable saying they are going to win, and I'll just be front and center watching everyone fight.
Okay, your last words. I start with you.
My last words, actually, they go to my teammates. I'm so proud of them. And I'm sure tonight's game, they will put a very beautiful show for everyone who's going to come and watch us play. And I wish them best of luck.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. I'm so grateful to our sponsors who have been there for our team. Kumba University, KCB Bank, International School of Uganda, and yeah, those ones.
Mm.
Then my teammates, hope you're ready for the game. We have to fight this evening. It's at 7.
Thank you very much.
I love your personality. Yes. You know, I was still laughing. She has this softy personality, and where opponents can always take such a personality for granted. And then she will come and do you wonders. So take note of such people. I got to continue with a different story. I don't know whether you ladies will feel comfortable to stay on that show. As we do some little bit of women football. Mm-hmm. Are you comfortable with women football? Did you ever play football?
Yeah, when I was little, I used to play football. You know, football is for everyone.
Uh-huh, good, I like that. So basically, if you talk about women football in the country, we have the Women Elite League and we have the Women Super League in the country. What do you... Is there anything you can tell us about women football? Before we go to the Crescent Cranes team...
Okay, me, about football, there is nothing much I can talk about it, but I like the game.
Mm.
You know, football is a game where someone can learn football at any time. At, you know, at school, people have pitches.
Mm. It's a well
home,
set up.
Yes, so really, football is a game for anyone.
Okay.
Anyone can do football.
Like we have 366 days back to Nambole. I hope you'll be going. Sweetheart, do you have anything recommend you'd say about football?
With football, actually, it was my primary game. I started with football and played up to senior six.
Then you know football.
So when I joined university, I was like, let me only do volleyball.
So is there any club, women club, you support in the country?
Panel.
Or you just follow the national team of the women?
I only follow a bit on the national team of the women. Now, I only play football for fun. There is a league called the Interre League.
Hey!
So, the Weranyanji OGs,
okay.
We play.
So, which position do you play in football?
I'm a defender. I play six.
Good. You love being a defender.
Number four. Or I go in the defensive midfield six. Oh.
And you, which position did you play?
Banali. Leave me out of this.
Hey. Okay, Faith, in the just concluded in the last fixture of women, FUFA Women Super League, Kampala Queens taking on Olila High School. Of course, what we saw Fauzia Najemba scoring a debut of 2 goals there. And then, of course, Sharon Achien from Olila. Olila is a team, by the way, from Eastern Uganda. This time around, something I would love to talk before I highlight all the results. We have quite a number of teams from Eastern and Northern Uganda. In both the Women's Super League and then the Women Elite League. You have teams like Olila, you have teams like Paida Women Football Club, you have Lango Queens, then there's a team called Vision FC from Kitgum. What do you say about that, basically, about women football in the country?
Of course, Uganda is a very young nation when it comes to women football. On average, most Ugandan female footballers are, less than 24. So it really says there's still a lot Uganda is going to do in football. And for me, I quite like that many of the girls are very young and very diverse.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you look at Olila, a team from Soroti, and you're looking at teams from Kitgum,
Zombo,
Western, Pida. Like there's so much, like food right now, women's football is very diverse and it's giving everyone a chance to compete.
Mm-hmm.
I think also it helps that football is a sport where it's possible for teams to travel far and wide to go and play football, as opposed to most sports. Why, when push comes to shove, they would much rather have regional leagues. It's unpalatable, because I remember in volleyball here, when I used to cover, I think they would play like a few games into the season, then they would just give up halfway through. It's too expensive, it's too all these things. But where women's football is in Uganda, it's a very good place for any sport to be. One is they have the funding from FIFA, apart from FUFA.
Mm.
FIFA gives them money, the resources to make this possible. And I think there's more, I don't know, there's the amount FIFA puts into women's development, the development of the game. This is why we see teams cropping up from everywhere.
Mm.
That you would not normally see in other sports, because it would take fast numbers. And it's good that parents are even willing to let girls be out there playing football. Because, to be honest, if this was like 1999, 2000, and you're like an 8-year-old telling the mother, oh, I'm playing football, your mother is going to be like, are you crazy?
No, I
Why aren't you playing with dolls? Like, stuff like that. A lot has changed in the world, and it says a lot. For me, I like the fact that we have so many teams playing women's football.
Okay.
You see a player like Fazila Ikwapu, who came from Olila. She's now...
She went to play out and she came back. She's now with the Lady Dubs in Masindi in Western Uganda.
Yeah, so it says a lot about... I mean, Ikwaput can forget about her time playing in Europe and she's thinking of, let me go back.
Come and
know,
develop the country.
And restart my, you know, recharge my batteries. And for her, I'd say recharging, because she's still a very young girl.
She's a young kid indeed. Yeah, she is.
She's very young. She got an opportunity to go and play professional and it didn't work out necessarily. Mm. But she's back to
and
work
remember
again.
Remember, she was the Airtel FUFA Women Player of the Year.
Yeah.
Season 2017.
She drove a car about 19.
Yeah. She was young. But anyway, to move on, UCU Lady Cardinals managed to secure a win against She Corporates at, of course, UCU ground. Now, the most interesting part of it, the person who scored for UCU Lady Cardinals is actually a Kenyan by name Maureen Kinavudol. So you can really see that now we even have international players now playing in the league in the country as far as Uganda is concerned. So kudos to the Federation for trying so much. And FIFA, by the way, it's an initiative that we want to see equality in women. And then, of course, Kawempe Muslim, of course, our own Juliet Nalukenge, we hosted the other time, the captain of under 17, taking on a brace there against Uganda Matters, of course, at Kawempe. And then Mutesa won Roy University Women Football Club. Were beaten at home, at their home ground, at Ayukawoja ground. Of course, 3-0. Fauzia Ikwai put herself, as he put it there, is currently the top scorer, and of course with 3 goals. She scored a hat-trick in that game for Lady Dubs. Now, it can tell you clearly where women football is going, as we said it very, very there. Now, as we move on, apart from the women football, the league, the SACAFA women challenge senior team being summoned. Of course, the team has been slashed to around 27 to enable Farida Bulega and her assistant Ayub Khalifa to kind of prepare as we go to face some of the East African giants in the women challenge. What do you say about this team?
Of course, they are going into residential cup, and you understand why they are trimming that team. At the end of the day, they need only 23 players. And if you have 27, at least it's very easy now. I believe they probably already know who they're willing to, you know, to drop at this point in time, because the tournament is already almost upon us. It's, for me, this stage is always disorganizing and painful for me, for the players' sake, because right now there's so many hopes. People who have hopes.
There are some of the ladies
traveling.
Are
you've been summoned for the national team. You think you're almost there, and they'll be telling you no. And of course, now that the league has started, I mean, I think their pain will end a little quicker.
And I think today they are going to have some test match in the evening. But remember, they are currently in the morning hours, they trained at Lugogo Startime Stadium. That is as far as women football is concerned. Of course, Uganda is very rich in squad, having Juliet Nalukenge. Of course, you're having Asfa Nasuna. You're having the captain herself, who was the FUFA, Airtel FUFA Player of the Year.
Tracy.
Tracy was not the Airtel FUFA Player of the Year.
Also wondering.
Aturo was the one. Yes, the girl from West Nile, I think. She's the one who took it there. But anyway, we wish them good luck for that preparation. Now, of course, they say every bad beginning makes a good ending. Do we see that Sports Club Villa is trying to recover from the woes that they had last season and probably having that half pitch of training, but managing to go to a borrowed ground field at Bombo and scoring against Toro past Toro 4 goals. And thanks, kudos to Kyria Ambrose, my one all-time best, one of the best midfielders. Yes, I like him so much. He has faced a lot of challenges, so many negative criticisms, but he has made it out. What do you say about Villa this season?
I think, you know, Villa have, for me, they are the personification of when life gives you lemons, you make lemonade. Like, they've been horrible for the last season. They survived relegation by a whisker.
Yes.
And now, I mean, they've been given a second lease of life. And let me tell you, when you have a chance to prove a point that whatever happened last year was probably because of some issues that, you know, a few technical things here and there. It's they are really, for me, I like the fact that they've really adapted well to this season.
See, one of my youngsters there, one of the upcoming central defenders we have in the country, who is also the captain of under 20. That's, of course, none other than Gavin Kizito.
And the beauty for me with the Sports Club Villa in recent times is that players come and go, but the club remains. So they've showed a lot of nous in how they've played this year. Like, they take their opportunities when they present themselves. And,
Well, of course, away from that, in FUFA, FUFA Big League, we also have Paida Black Angels last week. Of course, we're whitewashed a little bit. I could call it a little bit disappointed at home by Saviors Football Club from Lira. That one, we call it a Northern Derby. It was not quite well, but we understand that Paida Black Angels has been able to reboost their team by getting one of the players on loan from Onduparak FC, Carbon Living, and of course, he's probably commonly called as Messi. And we hope it's going to be good for the team from Northern. But however, Paida and Mbale Heroes in the result group look to be more interesting. Well, as we finalize, remember that Uganda Cranes, the select team, is to go to Katakwi. Basically, we're going to meet the Northeastern team in the regional tour. Remember, as we prepare and plan for 366 days back to AFCON or back to Nambole on the 17th of this month. So this and much more will be coming in the subsequent bulletins and other more stories. But we want to wish you a very good weekend. Your last word?
No, we are going for a short break, Sharon.
I thought you were saying bye.
I heard you.
Okay.
Sportswoman is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.